of ion. So Kolmogorov's law of independent migration of ion, it is for only strong electrolyte. This Kolmogorov's law is in applicable for only strong electrolyte. Then what is the statement of Kolmogorov's law? It states that the limiting molar conductivity of any electrolyte, that is particularly strong electrolyte, the limiting molar conductivity of strong electrolyte is equal to sum of the limiting molar conductivities of cation and anion. For example, let us take Ab is a strong electrolyte. Okay, it undergo dissociation A plus plus B minus. Then what is the limiting molar conductivity of Ab, which is equals to the limiting molar conductivity of cation and the limiting molar conductivity of anion. Okay, so 3-4 examples also completed yesterday class. Okay, that is Kolmogorov's law of independent migration of ion. Then continuation, right? Note, take the note. So we have studied Kolmogorov's law with respect to molar conductivity. Okay, tell me, what is the statement of Kolmogorov's law? The limiting molar conductivity of an electrolyte is equal to sum of the limiting molar conductivities of cation and anion. It is a limiting molar conductivity. Now if I ask, what is the limiting equivalent conductivity of electrolyte? That is also same. That means, so what is the Kolmogorov's law with respect to limiting equivalent conductivity? Therefore, now with respect to limiting equivalent conductivity, it is also same statement. The limiting equivalent conductivity of an electrolyte is equal to sum of the limiting equivalent conductivity of cation and anion. The same statement, right? Kolmogorov's law with respect to limiting equivalent conductivity. Kolmogorov's law with respect to limiting equivalent conductivity. Write the statement. Kolmogorov's law with respect to limiting equivalent conductivity. Right, under note. Okay. Statement is, the limiting equivalent conductivity of an electrolyte is equals to the limiting equivalent conductivity of an electrolyte is equals to sum of the limiting equivalent conductivities of cation and anion. Sum of the limiting equivalent conductivities of cation and anion. Okay, so let us take example NaCl. So lambda naught equivalent conductivity of NaCl is equals to, tell me, it is lambda naught Eq Na plus lambda naught Eq Cl minus. Yes or no? Same. Then it is MgCl2. Lambda naught Eq Mg plus 2 plus what? Plus lambda naught Eq Cl minus, not 2Cl. Why? Do you remember? In solution topic we have studied, if you take 1 molar NaCl which gives to 1 molar Na plus 1 molar Cl minus. But if you take 1 gram equivalent, it is used 1 gram equivalent, it is also 1 gram equivalent. Whereas in case of 1 molar MgCl2, which gives rise to how many molar? 1 molar Mg plus 2, 2 molar Cl minus. It is a 1 molar, it is a 2 molar, it is 1 molar. It means molarity changes. What about normality? Because normality related to equivalent mass, equivalent weight. Therefore, if you take normality, 1 normality is equals to, it is 1 normal, it is also 1 normal. Normality does not change. Therefore, here gram equivalent also does not change. If you take, it is a 1 gram equivalent. it is also 1 gram equivalent, it is also 1 gram equivalent. Therefore, now this is the equation. Yes or no? Okay. Lambda naught, take down. Lambda naught MgCl2. Lambda naught EQ MgCl2 equal to lambda naught EQ Mg plus 2 plus lambda naught EQ Cl minus, not 2. If it is in molar conductivity, you should get a 2 into. Next, if it is a AlCl3, lambda naught EQ AlCl3 is equals to lambda naught EQ Al plus 3 plus lambda naught EQ Cl minus, in that way. Okay. Okay. This is in note. This is first point. Next. Second point is that how do you convert molar conductivity into equivalent conductivity, or equivalent conductivity into molar conductivity? Now tell me, for example, what is the relation between lambda m lambda eq? Lambda m is equals to n factor into lambda eq. No, similarly lambda naught m also equal to n factor into lambda naught eq. Can we write? But I want, what is the lambda naught eq equal to? Lambda naught m divided by n factor. Yes sir. Now for example, take down. For example, let us take MgCl2. So what is the lambda naught eq of MgCl2? Lambda naught eq, already written, no? Lambda naught eq MgCl2 equal to lambda naught eq Mg plus 2 plus lambda naught eq Cl minus. Okay. But here, this lambda naught eq is equals to lambda naught m by n factor. Therefore, lambda naught eq Mg Cl2 is equals to, in place of lambda naught EQ Mg plus 2, what should I do?
Lambda naught M by 2.
Okay. It means lambda naught M, it is of Mg plus 2 divided by N factor. What is the N factor of Mg plus 2?
2.
No. N factor nothing but a positive charge. It may be negative charge. It may be valency. It may be
acidity
or basicity. But in case of ion, charge. So therefore, N factor is 2. Here N factor is 1. Therefore, shall I write it is a 1 by 2. Okay. Plus, next it is a 1 by 1. Lambda naught M Cl minus divided by, that's it. Okay. It means the relation between lambda naught EQ, lambda naught M. Okay. So if you want to write, you know.
So lambda naught M is 2 Cl minus
H. Which one? No. It is lambda naught EQ, no? Mm. Lambda naught EQ equal to what? Lambda naught M by N factor.
2 Cl minus for lambda naught M.
No. Why you write 2 Cl minus? Now this value I am substituting here, no. That's okay. If this is a lambda naught M, this is 2. This is not lambda naught M, no? It is lambda naught EQ. Understand? What our doubt is, here lambda naught M, no. When lambda naught M comes, so it should be 2 Cl minus, no. It gives 2 Cl minus. But this is not lambda naught M, no. If it is lambda naught M, this is 1, this is 2. It is lambda naught EQ, it is 2 here, it is 1. That changes. So therefore, now tell me, general formula I want. Come on, tell me. Lambda naught EQ of any salt. Tell me, let me take AB salt. is equals to, can I take 1 by n factor? Yes or no? N factor of any positive ion into lambda naught m plus 1 by n factor of negative ion into its lambda naught m. Therefore, to calculate lambda naught eq, so we need to take lambda naught m, lambda naught and n factors. This is one important equation. We don't study in PU level this. We can expect questions. So this is also Kolras law only. Applications of Kolras law of finished. Next slide. Applications. Applications of Kolras law. Tell me. So, what are the applications of Kolras law of independent migration of ion? One. So Kolras law is applicable to in the calculation of limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte, right? One, calculation of limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte to calculation of degree of dissociation, that is alpha. 3, calculation of dissociation constant. Dissociation constant of weak electrolyte. 4, calculation of, this was the previous question of Pidin JEE, calculation of solubility and solubility denoted by S. Solubility product is Ksp. In chemical equilibrium we will study in detail about this solubility and solubility product. Here application we will study. 5, calculation of ionic mobility. Calculation of ionic mobility. One is calculation of limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte. Calculation of limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte. tell me. Usually, the limiting molar conductivity of strong electrolyte can be calculated. Why? We can calculate the limiting molar conductivity of NaCl because NaCl undergo complete dissociation. It gives rise to Na plus plus Cl minus. Okay. If it is undergo complete dissociation, its lambda naught NaCl equal to the lambda naught Na plus plus lambda naught Cl minus. This can be calculated easily. That is by Kolrath's law. The statement of the Kolrath is this only. So what Kolrath's law says? Kolrath's law says that the limiting molar conductivity of any strong electrolyte is equal to sum of the limiting molar conductivity of the cation and anion. But how to calculate the limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte? For example, let me take, it is acetic acid. Acetic acid undergo partial dissociation, it gives rise to acetate ion plus H plus. Can you write acetic acid for this equation? Lambda naught acetic acid equal to lambda naught acetate ion plus lambda naught H plus ion. No, this equation is not valid. Why? Because here, suppose if you take this equation, this acid must undergo complete annihilation, right? If it is undergo complete annihilation, then only it gives acetate and H plus ion. It do not undergo complete annihilation. Since it do not undergo complete annihilation, you cannot take complete, you know, these ions and these ions. So therefore, it is not possible to calculate the limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte by using this equation. But from the Kolrath's law application, it is possible. How? By using Kolrath's law, we can calculate the limiting molar conductivity of even it is a weak electrolyte by taking other strong electrolyte. How? For example, let us take, I want to calculate acetic acid, lambda naught CH3COH. Therefore, by taking remaining strong electrolyte, tell me, to calculate acetic acid, we want acetate ion, we want H plus ion. Can you tell me, any one strong electrolyte having acetate ion? I will take CH3COONA. It is strong or not? Why? All salts are strong electrolyte irrespective nature. It is a salt. Strong electrolyte. Next. Now this is covered. And H plus I want. HCl. So take any strong electrolyte having H plus. I will take HCl. But what is extra added here? We want acetate, we want H plus. But extra added is Na plus Cl minus. Therefore, minus lambda naught NaCl. It means it is a strong electrolyte, it is strong electrolyte, it is also strong electrolyte. By adding two strong electrolyte, subtract one strong electrolyte. So it will get weak electrolyte. This is the indirect method to calculate the limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte. But you cannot use this. This is not. Because weak electrolyte does not undergo complete annihilation. If it does not undergo complete annihilation, you cannot write complete ions. We doesn't know that how many ions are there. So for example, out of 100, only 2 or 3 undergo. 2, 3. So we cannot write that only 2 here, 2 here. Not possible. We doesn't know exactly what is the degree of dissociation. That's what this equation is not valid. That's what to calculate the limiting molar conductivity of any weak electrolyte by using strong electrolyte, it is possible. Okay, Radha. It is not possible to calculate the limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte directly. It is not possible to calculate the limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte directly. But it can be calculated. It can be calculated by using Kolrath's law. So take this. Okay, see here. This acetate ion CH3COO minus is called AC. AC means acetate. In NCERT textbook given AC. And H plus ion is called H. Acetate H. Therefore, this equation given in textbook like this, lambda naught ACH is equals to, tell me, lambda naught AC NA plus lambda naught HCl minus lambda naught NA Cl. So don't confuse, AC means acetate ion. Next, one more example. Take down. Lambda naught ammonium hydroxide is equals to what? To calculate ammonium hydroxide limiting molar conductivity, you should take the add two compounds having ammonium ion, OH minus ion. So add the two compounds, subtract one compound. Tell me, any compound having ammonium ion? Take ammonium salt, ammonium chloride, ammonium sulfate, anything. I'll take ammonium chloride, simple. Ammonium chloride plus. Add any compound having OH minus. That should be a strong. Sodium hydroxide. Then ammonium hydroxide is over. Then what is the left here? Extra. Excess is Na plus ion. Cl minus lambda naught. NaCl. Understand? Similarly, tell me this. Lambda naught barium hydroxide is equals to
barium chloride.
Take barium chloride. Okay. Lambda naught barium chloride plus
potassium.
There is a hydroxide, no? There are how many hydroxide?
Two.
Therefore, 2 into lambda naught NaOH. Yes or no? There are 2OH, no? 2OH, 2OH. Minus 2 chlorine, 2 Na. 2 into lambda naught?
NaCl.
Balance or not?
Yes.
In that way. So it is the first application of Kolrath's law. Next. Second application, calculation of degree of dissociation. Calculation of degree of dissociation. Tell me, in previous class we have studied, what is the degree of dissociation? Alpha equal to? It is a ratio of number of moles of electrolyte dissociated to the total number of moles of electrolyte taken. So therefore, alpha equal to number of moles of electrolyte dissociated divided by total number of moles of electrolyte taken. In, if you want in percentage, you can take 100. This is alpha. But alpha can also be calculated from the lambda naught. So alpha equal to lambda naught m by lambda naught. Lambda m by lambda naught m. So alpha equal to lambda m by lambda naught m. Where, what is the lambda m and what is the lambda naught m? Lambda m is? It is a molar conductivity at certain concentration. Molar conductivity at certain concentration. This is also molar conductivity, but what concentration? Infinite dilution. Therefore, it is a molar conductivity at concentration C. Next, lambda naught m is limiting molar conductivity. At what concentration? Infinite dilution. Then how do you calculate lambda m, lambda naught m? Namrata, what is the formula to calculate lambda m? lambda m is equals to k into 1000 by molarity. So when this formula can be taken?
CGS.
When k value given in
CGS.
Or if you take this formula, you will get lambda m in CGS. Okay, next, what is the lambda naught m formula? Lambda naught m equal to lambda naught a plus cation plus lambda naught, or else lambda naught cation, lambda naught anion. So therefore, you can calculate the lambda naught m, okay? Then you get alpha. Then if you want percentage, the percentage alpha is equals to lambda m by lambda naught m into 100. Okay, even from equivalent conductivity also can calculate. Okay, alpha equal to lambda m by lambda naught m. So therefore, alpha equal to lambda m by lambda naught m, I want equivalent conductivity. The same formula. If it is a equivalent conductivity given, come and tell me, what is alpha equal to? Lambda m, lambda eq by lambda naught eq into 100. Same. That means alpha can be calculated even from lambda m, lambda naught m. Important. Okay. Next, calculation of dissociation constant of weak electrolyte. Calculation of dissociation constant of weak electrolyte. Right, see, from the Ostwald dilution law, remember Ostwald dilution theory. Andhra. What Ostwald dilution theory? Not studying? From the Ostwald dilution law or dilution theory, there is a formula, K equal to dissociation constant of any weak electrolyte is equals to C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. This is the formula we will derive in Ostwald dilution theory. But here remember this only. So K equal to C alpha square by 1 minus alpha, where K equal to dissociation. Take down. K equal to dissociation constant of weak electrolyte, and alpha equal to degree of dissociation, and C equal to molar concentration, concentration in molarity. That is molar concentration. So C is molar concentration, molarity. Okay, all the terms. Now tell me, but we know that what is alpha equal to? Lambda m by lambda naught m. So alpha equal to lambda m by lambda naught m. Therefore, substitute alpha value here. Then what is the k equal to? C into, tell me, lambda m by lambda naught m divided by 1 minus, again it is lambda m by lambda naught m. Okay. Next is calculation of solubility and solubility product. Calculation of solubility, it is denoted by S, and the solubility product is KSP. Okay. Do you remember solubility formula? I have given solution topic. Can you tell me what is the solubility? Solubility equal to anybody? In the solution topic, we have solubility. Solubility of the gas, liquid, solubility of solid, liquid, 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 yes, sir. What is solubility? The number of grams of solute or the weight of the solute present in or dissolved in 100 grams of the solvent. Solvent. The number of grams of the solute present in or dissolved in 100 grams of the solvent is a solubility. 100 grams of the solution is weight percent. Weight percent. Right? So therefore mass percent. Okay. Solubility equal to, can we write mass of the solute divided by mass of solvent into 100. Okay. This solubility. But we want to study what is the relation between solubility and this molar, limiting molar conductivity. Now how it is related to this concept? Okay. We know that lambda m is equals to k into 10 power 3 by molarity. So this formula can be used when k value given in CGS. All right. Now this is we know. But here, when the lambda m equal to lambda naught m, it means when molar conductivity become limiting molar conductivity, then molarity become solubility. Remember this. When lambda m is equals to lambda naught m, then molarity become solubility. Therefore now substitute here, in place of lambda m substitute lambda naught m. Then in place of, that will be same, in place of m you can substitute solubility. But we want solubility. Solubility equal to k into 10 power 3 divided by lambda naught. So when this formula can be used? If k value given CGS. Okay. But if the k value given CGS, if it is in SI, S is equals to k by 10 power 3 into lambda naught. Say, wherever lambda naught m comes, you can also substitute with lambda naught eq. Okay. Because in case of weak electrolyte, particularly, lambda naught m is equals to lambda naught eq. Their n factor is usually 1 for weak acid, weak bases. Okay. This is if k value given. This side. Calculation of ionic mobility. Okay, so this ionic mobility is denoted by mu. Okay, tell me, how do you calculate ionic mobility? Ionic mobility mu is equals to, it is a velocity of ion. Velocity of ion, it may be cation or anion, divided by potential gradient. Right? So velocity of ion or speed of the ion divided by potential gradient. So which is nothing but ionic mobility. But what is the potential gradient? This is you studied physics also. Tell me. Potential gradient is equals to difference between the difference between the potential by
distance.
Distance between the charge.
By distance.
Potential gradient equal to distance between the distance or difference. Difference between the two points divided by distance between the two points. Means difference between the potential by distance between the
two points.
So therefore, potential gradient is equal to, it is a difference between two potentials divided by distance. Correct? Huh? Getting doubt. Book is good. Distance. Even book. Inside book noted. Distance between two potentials by difference between. Physics a little not the physical question. Vega inside noting. Difference between potential electrode divided by potential difference by distance between electrodes. Distance between two potentials. Okay, of course. Then distance between electrodes. Okay. So potential difference by
distance
between electrodes. Okay, fine. That is a potential gradient, right? So therefore, now next, there is a mu also be calculated. Suppose mu positive, it means ionic mobility of cation. Ionic mobility of cation equal to its limiting molar conductivity. It means limiting molar conductivity of cation divided by Faraday. This is one important shortcut formula. So that means we also know that 1 Faraday equal to 96,500 coulomb. We'll study in Faraday's law today class only. 1 Faraday equal to 96,500 coulombs. So therefore, tell me, mu positive, ionic mobility of cation equal to its limiting molar conductivity divided by 96,500. And mu anion is also equal to lambda naught negative divided by 96,500 coulomb. Okay. Can you tell me what is the limiting molar conductivity of H plus and OH minus ion? Okay, question. What is the limiting molar conductivity? What is the ionic mobility? What is the ionic mobility? Ionic mobility of H plus and OH minus ions in aqueous medium. Tell me. So what is the ionic mobility? So ionic mobility of cation anion H plus OH minus ion can be calculated. Mu H plus equals to, what is the formula? Lambda naught H plus divided by 96,500 coulomb. But we should remember lambda naught H plus. It is 349.6 approximately, can take 350 for calculation purpose. Is 96,500 will get answer. Similarly, mu OH minus is also equal to lambda naught OH minus divided by 96,500 coulomb. What is the lambda naught OH minus?
199.1.
Okay, you can take approximately 200 for calculation. You get approximate value, no problem. Okay, so in this we can calculate ionic mobility. But in 2016 question paper, NEET, they ask for a question based on ionic mobility. Okay, so listen, this is important. Ionic mobility of any ion is also depends on two important factors, that is hydration and of course hydration energy. Therefore, ionic mobility in aqueous medium is depends on hydration, and which is related to hydration energy. Tell me, ionic mobility of ion in aqueous medium is depends on hydration energy. Okay, so what is hydration and hydration energy? You might have studied in alkali metal, and moreover we will study in detail in chemical bonding topic. Okay, anyhow, now tell me, what is the hydration? Hydration is when an ion is added, even salt is added or alkali metals are added to water or any solvent. So water molecule gets surrounded by ions get surrounded by water molecule. Like for example, when sodium is added to water, this sodium ion gets surrounded by many number of water molecules. It's because water has a dipole. Water has two polarity, Na plus charge. Therefore, this Na plus attracted by the oxygen, no, O minus. So there is a attraction between Na plus O minus. So due to attraction, so many water molecule comes near to Na plus and they get surrounded by Na plus ion. This phenomenon is called hydration. Okay. Then even sodium chloride also. When sodium chloride is added, you know, the same reason in yesterday class I told you. What is the, when salt is added to water, any salt. When salt is added to water or any solvent, what is the function of water? What is the nature of water there?
To dissociate.
Yeah. Water can dissociate or water can separate the cation and anion. It is a property of the water. It is a property of the solvent. Right. Since water has highest dielectric constant, it can easily separate cation and anion. That phenomenon is called ionization. Now, why it is get separate? Because the reason is this. Na plus Cl minus ions will be there. In between two ions, water enters. Therefore, this water comes closer to Na plus, and some of the water molecule gets surrounded by even Na plus Cl, surrounded by what? Water also. That means, so due to association or due to hydration, so these two ions get separated. Okay, fine. Now, this phenomenon is called hydration. But our question is, what way hydration related to ionic mobility? So, for example, order of hydration. Can you tell me? Order of hydration of alkali metals. lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. So which ion get hydrated more?
Lithium.
Smaller ion. So lithium is a smaller ion. Smaller ion, you know, it has more effective nuclear charge on outermost shell. Okay, therefore smaller ion attracts more ions. Therefore, the hydration of lithium plus greater than sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Okay, hydration more. So what is the meaning of hydration more? It attracts, lithium attracts many number of water molecule in many layer, not only one layer, in many layer. Therefore, hydration more. What is the hydrated size? More. Therefore, next, what is the order of size of the hydrated ion? Same, no? Lithium plus sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. What is the order of size? Lithium greater than sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Size also lithium plus more. But we want ionic mobility. Okay, when electric current is passed through the electrolytic solution, through the water, which is having these ions. Tell me, which ion can move fastly towards electrode?
Cesium.
Cesium, no. Smaller the ion. So, if the ion has smaller the size, it has more ionic mobility. Right? So, ionic mobility is depends on size. Right? It's just like, you know, there are two person, one person carrying 10 kg weight, another person carrying 100 kg weight. Yaar bega running race load tar
10 kg.
Obviously. Right? The person who carry less weight move faster or not? Same here also. Lithium carrying many number of water molecule. Okay. So therefore, it cannot move very fastly. Whereas, cesium plus. But slim irutte. But fast agi. Nantara fast agi odutte. Okay. Right? So therefore, now we want ionic mobility. So what is the order of ionic mobility? Lithium plus sodium plus potassium, rubidium, cesium. Okay. So this question asked. So ionic mobility is also. And moreover, hydration energy, can you tell me? Order of hydration and even hydration energy also same. Same order. ಅಕ್ಕಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿರಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಹಿಂದೆ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವಿನುತ next is electrochemical cell. Okay, so here we are again, one part of our electrochemistry. Next, electrochemical cell. Now in this part we are going to study what is electrochemical cell. Electrochemical cells are two types. So those two types of electrochemical cells in detail we will study. In first type we study Faraday's law, in second type we study galvanic cell and SHE. And third part is battery and cells. That is just one day class. I don't know the concept, but it is a model. Okay. So this one major part is completed. This is one more major part. Finish as well as possible. Okay. Electrochemical cell. So the name itself gave meaning. Electrochemical. A device which is used to convert electrical energy into chemical energy. And chemical energy into electrical energy. And moreover, the aim and scope of this topic is same now. In electrochemistry, what we study? In electrochemistry, we will study how to convert electrical energy into chemical energy. And how to convert chemical to electrical. But so far, have you studied that concept? Now, whatever you have studied so far, you have studied basics only. You have not studied how to convert electrical to chemical, chemical to electrical. Now, this, today onwards, we start, we will study about this. How to convert chemical to electrical and electrical to chemical. Therefore, electrochemical cell is a device or cell which is used to convert chemical energy into electrical energy and electrical energy into chemical energy. And there are two types of electrochemical cells. One, electrolytic cell. Second one is galvanic cell or voltaic cell. There are how many types? One, electrolytic cell. Second one is galvanic, which is also called galvanic or voltaic cell. Okay. Tell me, electrolytic cell. First, other word definition. Electrochemical cell. The device which is used to convert electrical energy into chemical energy and vice versa. The device which is used to convert electrical energy into chemical energy, vice versa, called electrochemical cell. Called electrochemical cell. Listen, first one is electrolytic cell. Tell me, in electrolytic cell, it is also cell or device which is used to convert chemical electrical energy into chemical energy. Therefore, now in electrolytic cell, by passing the electric current, we can convert the electric current to electrical energy into chemical energy. Therefore, the device, the cell which convert electrical energy into chemical energy, which is called electrolytic cell. So, electrolytic cell. So, in this electrolytic cell, we will study Faraday first law, Faraday second law, and what is electrolysis. So, many more important concept comes under this topic. Next, second one, galvanic cell. It is opposite. In galvanic cell, the cell which is used to convert chemical energy, by using chemical energy, we will produce electrical energy. That is a Daniell cell, the best example. By using Daniell cell, we will produce current. Even SHE, standard hydrogen electrode, will produce electric current. Therefore, where chemical energy get converts into electrical energy. Okay? Then, here is Daniell cell example. Here you can take many more cells are there, but here important cell is copper electrolytic cell. Okay, right on. Electrolytic cell. The cell which is used to convert electrical energy into chemical energy. The cell which is used to convert electrical energy into chemical energy called electrolytic cell. Called electrolytic cell. Take the conversion example, copper electrolytic cell. And we will study in detail about this cell also. Next is galvanic cell or voltaic cell. the cell which is used to convert chemical energy into electrical energy. Chemical energy into electrical energy called galvanic cell or voltaic cell. Example, Daniel cell. Okay. Okay. The second part of the electrochemistry completely depends on these two concepts. So, you know, the working of this cell is completely different from this cell. That's what first we'll study about this cell in detail. And next we'll study this cell. Okay? Try to understand, because even if you understand synopsis concept, then only we'll be able to do the questions. Okay. Now let's see. Electrolytic cell. So, as we know that electrolytic cell is the cell which is used to convert electrical energy to chemical energy. Okay? Then, now, electrolytic cell consists of electrodes. It consists of two electrodes. We can take cathode and anode. Okay? And these two electrodes are placed in where? Any electrolytic solution. Okay. Now, here important is how they are connected to whether battery required or not here. Tell me. In electrolytic cell, battery is required. Why? The source of energy is battery, no, here. So it is connected to battery. I'll take this is a negative electrode, positive electrode. Tell me, negative electrode, it is called anode or cathode? In electrolytic cell, negative electrode is? Cathode. Because when it is called cathode always attracts cation. In order to attract cation, it should have negative charge. If electrode has negative charge, it attracts cation. Then it is an anode. Why? Anode attracts anion. In order to attract anion, it should have positive charge. That's it. Okay. So this is negative and positive charge, cathode and anode. Now both electrode connected to battery. It is a positive terminal and it is negative terminal. Okay. Now all right. See here. One. Listen first. In electrolytic cell, cathode carry big charge. Cathode carry. Negative charge. And anode carry positive charge. And cathode carry negative charge and it is connected to negative terminal of battery. And anode carrying positive charge, it is connected to positive terminal of battery. Okay, next. Okay, when electric current is passed, here battery is there, so through the battery current will be passed. When electric current is passed through the solution, electrolytic solution, now tell me, cation moves towards cathode, anion moves towards anode. Let me take, this is a cation is A plus and anion is B minus. Okay, now A plus cation, when the current is passed, A plus cation moves towards what? Cathode. B minus anion moves towards? Obviously towards anode. Okay. Now, what is the flow of current? Current flow from where to where? Now, first the flow of electron. First, let me say flow of electron first. What is the flow of electron? In electrolytic cell, the flow of electron from negative terminal to positive through the solution. No? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
There is a flow of electron from negative terminal to positive terminal, that is cathode to anode, through the solution. Okay. Then what is the flow of current? We know that flow of current always opposite direction of flow of electron. Current is, let us say, I. Okay. So therefore, tell me, flow of electron from where to where? Cathode to? Cathode to anode through the solution. And next, what is the flow of? Now, what about, wait, what about the flow of electron from external circuit? It is internal, no? From externally, from outside the solution. Where it is? From here to here?
It's the
flow of electron. And what is the flow of current from outside circuit? It's always opposite. Yes or no?
Yes.
It is inside, not. It makes circuit is completed, no. So therefore, now flow of electron, it is anode to cathode. Okay, it is outside solution. Next, what is the flow of current? Tell me, flow of current is, it is opposite direction to the flow of electron. Here, flow of electron cathode to anode, therefore here anode to cathode, it is through the solution. Outside solution is opposite. So here questions are based on flow of electron, flow of current, and what is the charge of the cathode, what is the charge of the anode. But see, in Daniell cell, that is in galvanic cell, this is the electrolytic cell. We have two type of cells. One is a electrolytic, second one is galvanic. In electrolytic cell, electrical energy converts into chemical energy. In galvanic cell, chemical energy converts into electrical. And the representation of charges also, no, electrode also important. In case of electrolytic cell, cathode is, it is here cathode is negative, but there you will get positive. Daniell cell positive with that. Next, anode here is positive, but there is
negative.
Okay, but you know the reaction at anode and cathode same. So what is the reaction at anode? Anode always oxidation. Remember, anode oxidation. At anode oxidation takes place. At cathode reduction takes place. They are also same. Even in Daniell cell, at anode oxidation takes place. At cathode reduction takes place. But only the sign of the electrodes are opposite. Okay. Here negative positive. There positive negative. Okay. That's only different. And the flow of electron here is. Flow of electron, there will get different. Here flow of electron, flow of current. Okay, better. Electrolytic cell. It consists of two electrodes. Cathode and anode. Copper electrolytic cell. Example for electrolytic cell. Copper electrolytic cell. Okay. Right. It consists of two copper electrodes. Take them. It consists of two copper electrodes act as what? Cathode and anode. consists of two copper electrodes act as cathode and anode, comma, they are dipped in or placed in. They are placed in aqueous copper sulfate solution. They are dipped in or placed in aqueous copper sulfate solution. Act as electrolyte. Act as electrolyte. Okay. Next. Two copper rods are connected to battery. Okay. Now tell me. So two copper rods are connected to battery. This copper rod is cathode anode. It's negative pole. It is a positive pole. So negative is a
cathode.
Here is
anode.
Now what is the reaction takes place? Now let now tell you first reaction at anode. Reaction at anode. So at anode always undergo oxidation. Remember, at anode oxidation takes place, at cathode reduction takes place. Where anode is copper rod, no? This is a copper rod. Even cathode also
copper
rod only. So anode is a copper rod. Tell me, since anode is a copper rod, this copper rod undergo oxidation. What is oxidation? Cu copper rod gives rise to Cu plus 2 plus 2 electrons. That means this copper rod get undergo oxidation, which releases what ion? Which ion? Cu plus 2 ion. Those Cu plus 2 ion enter into the solution. And then when it undergo oxidation, the weight of the copper rod slowly decreases. Yes or no? That is reaction at anode. Next, what is the reaction at cathode? In cathode, which reaction takes place?
Reduction.
Okay, reduction here. Tell me, this is a cathode where copper rod is reduction. Copper rod reduction takes place. What is the reduction? Now, this copper sulfate solution has Cu plus 2 ion and
SO4
minus 2 ion. Among Cu plus 2, SO4 minus 2, which ions are attracted by this cathode?
Cu
plus 2. Because negative charge electrode attracts cation. Therefore, these cations are attracted by the cathode. Therefore, at cathode, what happens? Reduction takes place. What is the reduction? Cu plus 2 plus 2 electron, it becomes Cu. It means the Cu plus 2 ions present in the solution, they undergo reduction and they get deposited. Copper, they undergo reduction to form copper. That copper gets deposited on where?
Cathode.
On cathode. It means, now during this reaction, the weight of the anode is
decreases.
Means anode here, the copper dissolved from anode and copper get deposited on cathode. Then how much anode is weight loss, how much cathode weight gain, it is equal. The loss of the anode weight is always equal to the gain of the cathode weight, obviously. Okay, then you may have doubt. Yeah, one is sulfate. What is the use of sulfate? Sulfate is not required anything. It's no sulfate here, because here is oxidation, it's reduction. Sulfate ion does not involve in the reaction, in this particular reaction. But the doubt is, question is, what is the use of this? Both are copper rod, one is weight is losing, another weight is gaining. Okay, then what is the fun of doing this? Yes, there is a use in the purification of copper. See, this particular method is used in the purification of copper. Okay, in electrochemistry, in metallurgy, copper can be purified by
electrometallurgy process. This is the method is used in electrometallurgy. So how copper can be purified? Suppose you have impure copper. So what we do is, impure copper is made up of this anode, or anode is made up of impure copper. So they take, this is an impure copper. Suppose we have taken impure copper, and this is a cathode is made up of pure copper. So take pure copper, impure copper, two electrodes, and you do as the same arrangement. Then tell me what happened. In impure copper, copper is dissolved, which is get deposited on pure copper. Then if you go on do this process for a long time, then what happened? Whatever the copper is present in impure, the whole copper get dissolved and deposit here. That means, so impure copper can become pure copper. Right? This is the electrometallurgy process. Okay. So in Badri, take the diagram. What is the last sentence? Connected to battery, brother. Okay, then reaction. Reaction at cathode, reaction at anode. Take the reaction at cathode and reaction at anode. And take the diagram. Don't write this. In this process, copper dissolved at cathode, at anode, copper rod dissolved at anode, due to oxidation. Copper rod is dissolved at anode due to oxidation, and copper get deposited on where? At cathode due to reduction. It is used in purification of copper. It is used in purification of copper by electrometallurgy process. In the purification of copper, anode is made up of what? Anode is made up of impure copper or pure copper?
Impure,
because it gets dissolved, no? Anode is made up of impure copper, comma, cathode is made up of pure copper. On passing the electric current through the electrodes. Impure copper dissolved. Yes or no? Impure copper dissolved. Where dissolved?
in electrolytic solution, impure copper dissolved in electrolytic solution and impure copper dissolved in electrolytic solution and pure copper get deposited on cathode. No, pure copper get deposited on cathode.